We were discussing chapter number 6. It is molecular basis of inheritance. In this chapter, previous session, we have learned regarding the regulation of gene expression. And now today we are going to start with another important topic, which is called as Human Genome Project. So let's start with the Human Genome Project. So here first we will discuss today is Human Genome Project. Clear? So what is a Human Genome Project? Human Genome Project can shortly be called as HGP, Human Genome Project. If you discuss this Human Genome Project, the purpose of this project is to determine what is the base sequences that present in the structure of a DNA in a human. That means we want to determine the base sequences present in the human DNA, because it has a number of advantages once we find it, or it has a lots of applications. So that's why we want to find it out, this Human Genome Project. Okay, here this project has been launched initially by the United States in the year 1990. Okay, this project was launched by the United States in the 1990. This project was launched by initially by Department of Energy, United States of America. Then another one is NIH, that means National Institute of Health, NIH. Later on, Wellcome Trust, it is the initial partner. This is from UK. They have participated in it, and they found that this project is so big, it cannot be handled by even a single country. Though these are the developed countries, they have a lots of resources, but the complexity and the diversity and the nature of the project is such that it cannot be single-handed by any one country. It requires lots of resources and the use of different types of scientists. So later on, the certain other countries have also joined, and like France, Germany, Japan, these are the few countries which have joined with it. Even the China, they have joined with them, okay, and they have finished this product. This project has been finished in year 2003. That means it took 13 years to finish this project. Why it took so much time? Because there are lots of complexities they are associated with it. Just I will tell you the few complexities which are associated with it. You know that here we want to find out the sequences of the bases in the human DNA. Okay? So suppose you know that how many number of bases are present? 3 billion bases are present in the human DNA. It is well established fact. In the initiation of a chapter, we have learned that there are 3 billion bases are present. Okay, or 3 into 10 base to 9 base pairs are present. Now, even if you consider, okay, the $3 cost to find a single base, just the $3 cost, okay, to find a single base, $3, that means you have 210 rupees, okay, then also the cost of a project goes $9 billion. Okay, how much? It becomes a $9 billion. Okay, clear? I write down at the last so you can easily understand. It becomes a $9 billion. That means it involves a very huge cost. Okay, this is a one thing. Second thing, there is a problem that is related with storage. Now, we are identifying and then we are writing. Like suppose if you are taking a reading of some experiment, then you are noting down in the notebook. Now here we have to identify how many bases, 3 billion bases we have to identify and we have to write. And when we are writing, then what happens? Then it requires, suppose assume that if there is a book, okay, in this book, on each page, you are writing 1000 letters, 1000 letter means on one page you are writing the 1000 letter. Now this book has a 1000 page. Then it requires 3300 books to store this information. Okay, I again repeat, what is the complexity that is a storing in it? Once we find it out, we report it, we store it, we write it. So तमे assume करो कि एक book नी अंदर 1000 page छे. On each page you are writing the 1000 letters, then it requires such 3300 books to even write the sequences. So how much big information it is? It is a very big information. Okay, 3300 books it requires. Every book has a 1000 page and every page has 1000 letters. Then this information can be stored. Now from this 3300 book, if you have been told to find out what is the sequence present on the so-and-so chromosome, then again it becomes a very difficult. So there is again one more difficult is archiving. It's, or you can say, retrieving the information. And even there is also information problem in the analysis of the information. We want to get something. We are not just stopping out here that just we found the sequences and we just stop. It's not like that. We have to analyze the information. Whatever the information that we obtain, we have to analyze it. We have to retrieve it. Like suppose if you want to know that what is the information present on chromosome number 5 and so location, then how can we have to retrieve? We have to apne 3300 books madhi shodhu pade, and that is a very much difficult. Okay, so these are the problems with the use. One is the cost, very huge cost. Approximate cost is $9 billion. Even if you consider a $3 cost to find a one bit. Second is the problem of storing this information. It requires a very huge data. It is a very huge data, so it needs a lots of storage. And third thing is that if you want to retrieve the information, if you want to analyze the information, if you want to archive the information, then again it's a problem. So this is a big information, and based on that, even the new branch of biology has also been evolved. This is the current new development. It's called as bioinformatics. This is the new branch. A new branch has been developed. Whatever the information that is present in the living organisms, we are capturing them. Okay, and even you can also perform your masters in this bioinformatics. This is the information you have to play with information. So this is challenges in the human genome project. These challenges the scientist has to overcome to finish this project, and that's why it requires the contribution of the different countries. Not even a single country can be able to handle this project. So this is the human genome project. Now let's start with what are the goals of this project. So we are moving ahead with the goals of human genome project. So next we are going to start with goals of human genome project. The first goal of human genome project is to identify 20,000 to 25,000 genes which are present. This is the first. Second one, in this gene you determine the sequence of bases, sequence of bases in structure of DNA. Which is the first, which is second, third, fourth, fifth, eighth. That means there is a determine the sequences. This is the second goal. Third goal of this human genome project is to store the information. This is the third. How to store this information. Okay? Fourth one is, it's a development of better analyzing tools. See, for its analysis, The human cannot do its analysis. Okay, so that's why we have developed a very fast computers. Okay, like suppose if you want to recognize so and so number of thing, you cannot recognize all the thing, but once you feed it in computer, it will be stored in the computer memory. But you have to develop a very high speed computers, very high speed computers, because it has a lots of information and the retrieving becomes a very tough. So that's why the development of a variety of improving tools, analyzing tool, it is also one of the major challenge or goal of this HGP. Next is, here you can say that, here that once we develop it, transfer this tool, transfer it to an industry. This is the next goal, transfer it to an industry. So these are the basic goals of Human Genome Project. Identify the genes. Second, determine the sequences of bases in DNA. Store the information. Improve the better analyzing tools and transfer it to an industry so they can utilize this information to develop a better solution for the better living of a human being. So this is a goals of Human Genome Project. Now, ultimate goal is to determine the sequences. So what are the methodologies or what are the methods they have adopted? So now we are moving ahead with the methods. Okay, so what are the methods of Human Genome Project? So now we are going to discuss with methods of Human Genome Project. In the methods of Human Genome Project, there are two approaches. There are the two approaches which have been adopted in the Human Genome Project. The first approach that is done is to determine the sequences which are expressed. This is the first approach. Those sequences, we have very long DNA which consists of 3 billion base pair. Okay, from this we are just determining the sequences they are expressed, means which can be transcribed, like jemati mRNA bane chhe. And this is the first approach. This is called as expressed sequence tag. This is called as expressed sequence tag. A simple approach evo chhe ke here instead of running the whole syllabus, you are just preparing the important things from this syllabus. This is called as expressed sequence tag. This is the first approach. Second approach is such as that here you are determining whole sequence, whether it is expressing or not expressing, means it is coded or not coded, we are not checking it first. We are determining the whole sequence, okay? And then what we are doing? We are annotating the coding sequence, means the sequences which are expressed. And this method is called as sequence annotation. What it is called as? Sequence annotation. Clear? So these are the two approaches or the methods which are adopted in the Human Genome Project. Okay, first one is first to determine the sequences they are only expressed. This is called as expressed sequence tag. Okay, clear? I write down the full form. Expressed, E means expressed, S means sequence, and T means tags. And the second approach is we are determining the whole sequence and we just annotate the coding sequences, and this method is called as sequence annotation. So these are the basic two approaches we can adopt to find out the Human Genome Project or to determine the sequences that is present in the Human Genome Project. But if you want to analyze the whole DNA, the DNA is too much long, it is a 2 meter long, you know it. So it is not possible to determine the sequences of whole DNA at a time. So what we are doing, we are making its fragments. We break them, we make its pieces or fragments, and we determine the sequences in the each fragment, and then we gather the information of each fragment. So here, how we are doing? Here, first of all, the fragments are going to be formed. Fragments are going to be formed. These fragments, the fragments which are going to be formed, they are analyzed. Okay, they are analyzed. Okay, these fragments, they are inserted into a host cell. They are inserted into a host cell. First, we have collected a DNA. What we have to do? In these two approaches, first the collection of DNA. I am writing over here. First, there is a collection of DNA. Okay, then once the collection of DNA, then we break the DNA to make the fragments. So this is called as fragmentation of DNA. Now it is converted into pieces. These pieces are transferred to a host cell. Okay, this transfer is carried by a vector. Something is required to transport or transfer the DNA to a host cell. This is what we are calling as a vector. Means the fragments are transferred to a host cell with the help of a vector, and then here we are performing a process called as cloning. Cloning means we are making its copy. Okay, and when we are making a copy, so it is very easy to identify them or to identify or to determine the sequences. This is a procedure what we perform. Okay, so here we are cloning, making its multiple copy. We are making its multiple copy by inserting into a host cell with the help of a vector. Okay, usually the host cell are, who can act as a host cell? A DNA apne ko same I introduced kariye chhe, that is a bacteria and the yeast. They are acting as a host cell. Now who can act as a vector? Vector means which carries or which transfer the DNA into a host cell. This is called as a vector, or that carries a DNA into a host cell, which we are calling as a vector. So who can act as a vector? I am writing the name of vector over here. Here the who can act as a vector, that is BAC and the YAC. They are acting as a vectors. What is a BAC? Bacterial artificial chromosome. Bacterial artificial chromosome. And the YAC, that is yeast artificial chromosome. These two are acting as a vector. Okay, clear? I again repeat, these are the two approaches, or these are the two methodologies. In the first methodology, we are just only determining the sequences they are expressed. This method is called as expressed sequence tag. In the second method, we are determining the whole sequences and we annotate the sequence they are expressed. This is called as sequence annotations. But it is very difficult to identify and determining the whole sequences as a whole. So we make the fragments of DNA. These fragments of DNA are inserted into a host cell with the help of a vector. And we do a cloning. Here the host cell are the bacteria and the yeast, and the vectors are bacterial artificial chromosome and the yeast artificial chromosome. They are acting as a vector to carry or transfer the DNA into a host cell. Now here these are the fragments. Now once the fragments are formed, tukda jai gaya, then we have to determine which is the first fragment, second, nijo tukda kayo, trijo kayo, chautho kayo. Means we have to identify which is the sequence of fragment. And this sequence of fragment can be determined by the method developed by Frederick Sanger. This Frederick Sanger, this is a scientist who has developed a method for automatic sequencing of this DNA. And with the help of this automatic sequencer is a machine. This machine has been developed on the principle of Frederick Sanger, and they have the fragments have been sequenced. And thus we can determine the Human Genome Project. So these are the methods which are adopted or which are used in determining the sequence of Human Genome Project. So till now we have studied what are the challenges of Human Genome Project. We have also discussed what are the goals of Human Genome Project. We have also discussed a methodologies of Human Genome Project. Now we are moving ahead with discussing regarding the silent features of Human Genome Project. Which are the silent features of Human Genome Project? This is very important, silent features of Human Genome Project. Silent features of Human Genome Project. Which are the silent features of Human Genome Project? The first silent feature of the Human Genome Project that we have identified, that human DNA has 3164.7 million nucleotide bases. This is the first feature. Human DNA has 3164.7 million nucleotide bases. This is the first silent feature of the Human Genome Project. Now the second silent feature. On an average, gene contains 3000 bases. Okay, clear? Average gene contains a 3000 bases. Okay, but the size of bases may vary greatly depending on the gene. This is the average. One gene contains a 3000 bases. In the human, the largest gene is dystrophin. Dystrophin is the largest gene. It contains 2.4 million bases. Clear? It is a 2.4 million bases are present even in this single gene. But on an average, the each gene contains a 3000 bases. This is the second feature. The third feature, or silent feature of a Human Genome Project, is that here in the Human Genome Project, if you see that, in these cases, there are 99% of the genes or sequence, nucleotide sequence, remains the same. 99.9% sequences that remains the same. Only the very few sequences that is going to be altered. Okay? How many number of bases genes are present? It was estimated that 30,000 genes are present. 30,000. The initial estimate that it is 80,000 to 1,40,000. But not that much number of genes are present. It is less. 30,000 genes are only present. Okay, this figure may vary. Initially, I have told you 20 to 25,000. But in the silent feature, you will write that 30,000 genes are present. The previous estimate was 80,000 to 1,40,000. Okay, but that is not correct. That means lesser than that. The next feature of this, only the 2% of the genes, even in some cases the 1% of the genes, are coding for proteins. They are just very few percentage that is coding for a protein. Okay, clear? So this is the sequence. Now, many times you can find the repeated sequences. These sequences are such as that which are repeated 100 to 1000 times. Ek ni ek jo vastu vare ghadi repeat tha. And they are not a coding sequences. They are not a coding sequences. But it gives us information regarding the structure, evolution, stability of a DNA. There are few sequences which are repeated number of times. Okay, even they are repeated 100 to 1000 times. and that doesn't, they are not coding sequences, but they give information regarding structure of DNA, stability of DNA, evolution of DNA. Okay, so this is the silent feature. Okay, next feature, you can say that here you can find SNPs. SNPs means single nucleotide, N means nucleotide polymorphism. So scientists have identified that, there are 1.4 million locations. How much? 1.4 million locations are such as that in the structures of DNA, which are just differ in single base. Ekaj base no difference on. And this is called as SNPs. Okay? This is pronounced as SNP. Okay? SNP. The full form is single nucleotide polymorphism. Robert, remember its pronunciation, it's called as a SNP. Okay? Here, the most number of genes, highest number, you can say highest number of genes are present in chromosome number 1. Which chromosome? Chromosome number 1. And the lowest number of genes, they are present on chromosome Y. On chromosome Y, only 231 genes are present, and in chromosome 1, 2900, it is something like 2937, something like this. You refer the exact numbers, but you can say that more than 2900 number of genes, they are present on the chromosome number 1. Okay, clear? So these are the silent features of Human Genome Project. I can repeat, human DNA has 3164.7 million bases. Second, on an average, the gene contains the 3000 bases. But the number of nucleotide in the base are greatly varied. The largest human gene is the dystrophin, which contains 2.4 million bases. 99% of the DNA sequence remains the same. Just only a 1% change is there, and that's why we look different. There are 30,000 genes. In total, 30,000 genes are present. The previous estimate was higher. It was 80,000 to 140,000. But now we found that there are only 30,000 genes are present. Only 1 to 2% of the gene, remember, only 1 to 2% of the genes, they are coding for a proteins. There are many sequences that are occurring repetitively. They are called as repeated sequences. These sequences are repeated 100 to 1000 times, and they are not coding sequences, but yes, they give information regarding structure of DNA, stability of DNA, and the evolution of DNA. Next, here the SNPs are found. SNPs means single nucleotide polymorphism. Scientists have found the 1.4 million location in the structure of DNA where there is just a difference in the single base. This is called as SNPs. Highest number of genes are present on the chromosome number 1, more than 2900. Refer the exact numbers from the book. And the chromosome Y has lowest number of chromosomes. Lowest number of genes they have, it is 231. Okay, so this is about the silent features of Human Genome Project. Now, what are the future challenges and the applications? Now, here, once we have found the sequences of this Human Genome Project, now we require involvement of a different scientist to apply it into our real life to make it a better life. This is a real challenge. It needs a training of lots of scientists all over the world, from private and the public sectors, to find out its different applications. So this is the future challenge, and it can be applied lots of ways. Here, due to this, we are able to find out the gene therapy. This human genome sequences can be used in a forensic sciences. This can be used to diagnose the different diseases. It can also be used in the therapy, newer therapy of variety of disorders and diseases. So it's a lots of applications. Okay? So this is all about the Human Genome Project. In this Human Genome Project, what we have learned, its introduction, What are the challenges in the Human Genome Project? Who has participated in Human Genome Project? What are the goals of Human Genome Project? Methodologies or methods of Human Genome Project? Silent features of Human Genome Project? And last, we have discussed the applications and future challenges of Human Genome Project. That's all about the Human Genome Project. Students, it's very important topic, both for MCQ and the subjective point of view. So learn it thoroughly, keep learning, keep watching, like and subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching.